That's an eternity of basketball ahead of us.
Another beautiful steal perpetrated by Pat White. The action continues. The let's go situation here. Alex A. Deacon going up against a double team. Jeffrey Moore has perfect access to the bucket.
Wonder yourself on that normal replay of that last bit of action was Juan Fernandez actually wanting to dish up against Master Jaworski.
We're crossing the Twilight Zone.
That's an eternity of basketball ahead of us.
Welcome to Eternity of Basketball, episode 188, about to begin. We are part of the Globally Ballin Network. And you check out Who the Heck Are We? That's another show on the network. The episode 128 has Camille Rodriguez as their guest. Our most trending episodes on YouTube, number one is Mon Fernandez. Number two, Bernie Boggs is at three. All the way down to Oscar Rocha, maraming Chris Pat Toyota dyan, relevant to our show sa araw na ito. Globallyballin.com. Original articles, audio, and video projects. You can check them out on globallyballin.com. Catch our episodes live on Twitter as well. We are streaming on YouTube, Facebook, and now on Twitter, Globally Ballin Twitter page. And follow us on social media. Linktree/globallyballin for easy access to all of that we just mentioned. So here we go. Episode 188. Ako po si Charlie Cunha together with Jay Mercado. Just the two of us today. Other fellows, Noel and Sid, are busy attending to some stuff. But we're excited today, no? Because we've been trying to get this gentleman on our show for quite a bit. And if you were a CRISPA fan, you know who he is. Definitely played for CRISPA for a couple of seasons. Was a rookie in 79. Played for them for two seasons. Won two championships, the All-Filipinos, in those two seasons. And then transferred to the CFC franchise, Presto Enrich / Great Taste for his last two seasons in the PBA. Now known as an icon in Philippine motorsports. Mm-hmm. In fact, when we first mentioned him, some said, player pala yan? Hindi ba car racer yan? They know, mm-hmm. they know him more as a car racer, but obviously he was a PBA player and did play for Mama's Love, Ateneo de Zamboanga, and Southwestern University. Let's bring him in right now. We're very happy to have him. Sir Phil Gulfin is with us sa araw nito. Sir, good morning. Welcome to our show.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Yeah, salamat. You're finally here. Tagal na tayo nag-correspond about this. And now you're here to share your story with us. Sir Phil, let's start from the start, no? Ateneo de Zamboanga. So were you born and raised in Zamboanga?
Yes, born and raised in Zamboanga until I transferred to Cebu, which was playing for Southwestern University. Mm-hmm. So all of my years were in Zamboanga.
So yung bata po kayo sa Zamboanga, sino nag-impluwensya, sir, sa inyo na mag-basketball? Bakit hindi baseball? Bakit hindi football?
Baseball, ano?
Bakit basketball?
Kasi nung high school ako, hindi medyo lumaki lang kasi malaki yung pamilya namin. So medyo tumangkad ako. Eh, yung mga friends ko sabi, bakit hindi mo subukan mag-basketball? So I was like 5'11 at my third year high school. So at that time, medyo matangkad na yun eh.
Yes, yes.
So sabi nila, subukan mo, subukan mo. Sabi ko, mag-uumpisa pala ako. But I gave it a shot, made the high school varsity. So from then on, fell in love with the sport.
So doon ka lang nag-umpisa mag-basketball talaga at that age of third year high school. So before that, where were you playing any other sport?
Well, I was just there playing basketball, but really walang seriousness involved. Kumbaga, parang laro-laro lang, ganun. So, walang...
But okay. Jim and sir, na bago ko pala naglaro, how were you like as a player? Were you a reserve nung time na yon? Bench player po ba kayo? O talagang sinard na kayo kasi matangkad kayo?
Ano ako, more on a role player.
Okay.
Role player ako kasi... Skills wise, medyo wala pa eh. So medyo malaki lang, depensa, ganun, kuha ng rebound, then learn to block shots, parang ganun lang. Ganun lang yung role ko. Then eventually, yun, medyo na-develop ng konti yung skills. So
pero at that point in time, sir, may mga from Zamboanga, of course, were you able to watch the Mika and NBA or whatever other basketball tournaments that were being held? May mga idol ka na ba? Mga gusto mong gayahin? Ganun.
Well, kasi si, if you remember, Asyong Ihares is also from Zamboanga.
Yes, sir.
So, minsan umuwi siya na parang medyo na-starstruck kami kasi naglalaro siya sa Crispe. Tapos... he's also friendly with us. Nagbibigay siya ng mga pointers. So, pumasok sa isip ko na baka kaya may chance din ako. So, yun ang ano, yun ang...
Si Boy Ihares pala. Nag-guest na rin sa amin, sir. Nag-guest na si Boy Ihares sa show.
Yeah, good.
He's also shared. Shared his stories with us as well. So, we're in contact. Dapat pala sinabi ko sa kanya, ikaw yung guest ngayon.
Para oh, man.
Diba? But, sir, so para... mo, sa yung idol mo nung panahon, parang you looked up to him as someone who you could become like. You know, parang...
Si idol na, Bogs Adornado.
So sa yung idol, si Bogs. So napapanood mo siya.
Idol ko si Bogs. The way he plays, ganon. Tapos, hindi ko kalain na dun sa Crispa days, naging kasama ko siya, naging close ko siya kasi he was recuperating.
Correct.
Tapos nung recuperating times niya, we had like a lot of time together, kaming dalawa lang, nagsushooting lang kami. So doon ko nakita, ganito si Boggs.
Yeah.
Jay. So idol ko siya even before that.
What about that? What about sa NBA, sir? Were you already familiar with the NBA ano nun, nung time na yun?
That time, hindi pa. Pero Michael Jordan era, wala na yun. Mas tumigil na ako sa paglalaro nun. Michael Jordan era. Tapos ngayon.
So yung mga ABA, NBA era, mga Walt Frazier, hindi pa masyado.
Dr. J, di ba?
That's a common, common reply yan from your era of players who have been on our show. Dr. J talagang karamihan sa kanila. Eh. He was really the man, no? At that time.
Yeah, he was really the man.
Diba? Diba? Lumilipad talaga eh. So, when you were in Zamboanga, and medyo sikat din. Magagaling din naman ang mga taga-Zamboanga. May mga kapanahon ka ba, sir, sa Zamboanga na later on sumikat din? Nag-Mika, nag-PBA?
If you remember, nag-PBA si, Rudy Garcia. Rudy Garcia. Naging magkasabay kami pero nauna lang ako sa kanya sa PBA. Pero eventually was able to get into PBA. Pero now I think he's based abroad.
Okay.
So, 'yun. He's a good friend, Rudy Garcia.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yung transition from Ateneo de Zamboanga to ano, Southwestern University in Cebu. Paano nangyari 'yon?
Okay, nung meron akong kwento na very interesting din na when I was playing for Zamboanga, palarong pambansa 'yon. Tapos nung palarong pambansa, we were supposed to go to Lucena, yung buong team Western Mindanao. Western Mindanao yung team namin. Naging selection yon. Dapat Peter yung kukunin sa team namin. Tapos three players from other team like Holo, like Dipolog, yung ganon. Tapos meron isang hindi sumipot. May isang hindi sumipot. So, ang nangyari, 9 players came from our team except for one. So, during that time, ako yung, kumbaga, sa ranking, ako yung pang-7.
Oh,
so, dapat kasama ako doon. Ang pang-10 ang dapat may iwan. So, ang nangyari, ang sabi sa akin nung head of delegation, sabi niya, mas okay yung buhay mo kesa dito sa player na to. Ikaw na lang may iwan. Siya na lang dadali namin. Okay. So, I ended up the only one who was not brought to palarong pambansa that time. So, sumama yung loob ko. Siyempre, parang gusto ko talagang pumunta Experience yun palarong pambansa eh. Lucena City yun that time So, ngayon, ang ginawa ko ay I went to a cousin in Dipolog to have a vacation. Tapos, meron palang tournament doon. Basketball. So, nalaman nila na player ako ng Zamboanga. So ngayon, inano nila ako. Sabi lang, laro ka dito. Talagang laro ka. Tapos mamaya laro na. Ganun yung tournament. So sabi ko, sige. Okay. Gusto ko. So I ended up meeting a few people there. One is Ronnie Albor. I don't know if you know Ronnie Albor. Yeah. Ronnie Albor was at that time also playing for Southwestern. So siya nagsabi sa akin, halika, bye, halika, sama ka na sa amin. Tatanggapin ka ron sa Southwestern kasi medyo matangkad ka eh. So, I ended up na sama ako, sige, punta ako sa iyo. So, sumama ako. Tapos dun, the rest is history with Southwestern. Tapos nung after a month, nagre-recruit ang Mama's Lab ng medyo malalaking player, na-recruit din ako.
Ah, ganun kabilis?
Ganun
from the time you went to Southwestern, soon thereafter, nasa Mama's Lab ka na rin.
Oo. Kasi yung that time, yung Mama's Lab was recruiting na, sabi na kahit hindi, wala pang skills masyado, pero gusto namin matangkad. So, yun ang isa sa mga criteria niya. Ang coach namin was June Noel.
June Noel. Yeah. So, 6 plus ka na nun, sir? Tumangkad ka na rin?
Yeah. Mga 6'2 na ako nun. Okay. So, ni-recruit ako, pero I was like 2 taon, 76, 77, wala. Bench player talaga ako kasi mas magagaling talaga yung yung mga nauna sa akin.
Okay. Oh, so, maganda naman.
Another parang interesting story.
Talent mill naman talaga yung Southwest.
Oh, naman.
And Cebu in general was really producing so many great players.
At
so
yung rivalry ng SWU at UV, di ba?
Yeah. That time, nagkaroon ng rivalry the late Arnie Tuadles. Same time kami pumasok ng PBA, 79.
Correct. Yeah. Rookie of the year siya.
Noon sa Cebu, maganda yung rivalry namin, pero I didn't know he was that good when he went to the PBA. Ang galing niya talaga. Sobra.
Grabe siya. Mythical 5 siya agad eh. First year niya, di ba? Mythical 5 siya agad.
Yeah, Mythical 5. Yeah. Rookie Mythical 5 siya. Tsaka, magaling talaga.
Sir, may buwabati sa'yo. Bakit mo yan. Good morning daw sa ating tatlo, si Ramon Cruz.
Oh. Yeah. Sir, Ramon Cruz.
Former Crispa din yan.
Former Crispa, of course. And si Mon Cruz, since it's World Cup. Basketball World Cup next week, di ba? Noong huling nag-Basketball World Cup dito sa Pilipinas, yan ang top scorer ng team natin.
Yeah, the leading scorer of that team.
Yeah, diba?
Sir, balikan ko lang yung ano, yung palarong pambansa, interesado lang ako. How, two questions. Number one, how did Western Mindanao fare in that competition? And number two, when you mentioned na mas na may kaya kayo na mas ano, what does that mean? In other words, financially mas may kaya kayo kaya pinagbigyan yung isa. Ganun ba 'yon?
Well, parang ganun nga. Yung first things first, how did the team fare? Hindi naman. Hindi naman kami nag-podium noon, hindi naman yung team. Dun sa financially, oo, yun, mas financially stable yung family namin kaysa dun sa the rest of the ano. So okay. Yung head of delegation sabi, pagbigyan na lang natin to, kinausap ako, pagbigyan na lang natin to. Umuo ako, pero syempre, mabigat yun sa kalooban.
Okay. Basketball yung usapan, hindi naman finances eh, di ba? Mm-hmm. So, parang ginawang priority yung, anyway, but sige na, napagbigyan naman yung isang fellow na yun.
At diba? Saka serendipity, kita mo, SWU ka, na-discover.
Oo, it's a blessing.
Yeah, it was meant to be. It was meant to be.
Kasi kung sumama ako doon, malamang baka nasa Sambuanga lang ako. Hindi ako mag-strike. Hindi ko cha-challenge yung sarili ko na I have to prove something na kaya ko rin.
When you went to... Oh, sir, when you went to Southwestern, so you're playing with all these Cebuanos who are some of the best talaga until now, no? Ibang-iba ba yung laro? Ibang-ibang laro nila?
Ibang-iba. Ibang-iba yung laro. Alam mo naman, yung Visayan basketball, medyo kakain ka ng mais, di ba? Sipag mo, kailangan takbo ka ng takbo, talon ka ng talon. Yeah. Nandoon yun.
Yeah. Yan din sinabi ni Willie Tanduyan, di ba?
Ay, oo. Si Willie. Si Willie, kahit na hindi kumain ng mais yun, kaya nun.
Aldo Perez, good morning as usual. Si Aldo, nanonood na naman.
Yeah. Diba? Naging guest na namin si Willie Tanduyan kasi, sir. Kaya, okay. And it was,
one of the funniest episodes and then colorful, also, and very emotional also towards the end. So, Yeah, that was a good episode. So yung nasa Mama's Love kayo. So it was allowed to play for a school and a commercial team at the same time sa Cebu.
Yes, it was allowed.
So, ayun. Mm-hmm. Anong
receiving something?
Yeah, allowances.
Yeah, allowance.
But we were also employed.
Oh, okay.
So we work like there are some hours that we work.
As what?
So, huh?
As what?
Part of the factory. Ako, I work as a like a storage manager. Parang ganun. Yung ano, tapos may kailangan sila. Ako pero I work only like 2 to 3 hours a day. Tapos kung may practice na, tatawagan nila kami o may practice na. Alabas. So, dun kami binabayaran. So, okay. That time meron ng ganun.
Ganun pala.
Oo nga, ang galing, no? Nag-aaral ka na, may ano ka pa.
So, Mama's Love. And did you think, no, Mama's Love, after you played for them, talagang sumikat pa rin talaga yan into the 80s and everything, you know, with all these popular players, di ba?
Jojo Lastimosa days, yun ang pinakasikat nung Mama's Love.
Yeah.
Yun ang pinakasikat na...
Yeah, hanggang Manila kasi, naglaro sila dito sa PABL, di ba? And then they really brought... a different brand and a good brand of basketball dito. Oh. Pero parang ang bilis na mga pangyayari, sir, sa basketball career mo, no? Sadi, you find yourself from Sambanga, you're in Cebu, you're playing for Mama's Love, and then before you know it, it's 1979, you come to Manila. How did you end up coming to Manila to play for the Crispa amateur team?
Well, as somebody said, that day, I was already eyed for recruitment.
Okay.
Pero... hindi inantay nila. There was a national intercollegiate 1979 March in Baguio.
Okay.
So naglaro kami Southwestern Championship noon is Southwestern against UE. So UE ang nakalaban namin si Dong Distrito.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Si Dong Distrito. So we won that championship. Pagbaba, hinarang na ako. Sabi, ano... pwede ba maglaro ka na? So I was recruited for Crispa Mika'a Amateur. Mm-hmm. The likes, mga kasama ko noon sila Steve Watson.
Mm-hmm.
Yun yung batch na yun. Then, mabilis din yung pangyari. 5 games lang ako doon. Tapos ni-recruit nila. Ay, open recruitment noon, walang drafting. So, dito ka na. Akyat ka na sa pro. Kasi may offers din ako sa two other teams na hindi naman ganun kalakasan, pero sa pro din.
Mm-hmm. So, ano sir, ano team yun, sir?
Anong team yun?
Honda.
Okay. Sina Albor. Honda.
Saka, meron pa isa basta dalawang team yun. Okay. Pero yung Honda, hindi ko makalimutan. Mm-hmm. Kasi nandun din sila Ronnie Albor.
Sila.
Right. So, nakapaglaro sila doon. Meron, ano, kalimutan ko. Anyway, I'll get back to that.
Oo. Pero ang galang bilis, kasi ang bilis talaga. Imagine, you played in the Mika for just 5 games. What was it, you know, now that you look back, what was it that made them, after just 5 games, bring you up? Sobrang ganda ba ng laro mo doon sa 5 games na yun?
Oh, medyo maganda. Medyo talagang, medyo tumatak yung laro. Mm-hmm. Tumatak yung laro. So, nag-decide sila na i-recruit ako for the pros. Ngayon, ako naman, 21 years old ako eh. Kasi 1979 yun, 1958 born ako eh. So, 21 mm-hmm. years old ako. Medyo neophyte pa ako sa mga ganun. Wala pang nag-a-advise sa akin. O, wag muna, hindi ka pahinog. Or yun, di ba? Yung mga nung araw. Relax ka lang muna, pahinog ka. Antayin mo yung magandang pagkakataon. Pero sa akin naman, sabi ko, ito na yung pinaka magandang team na pwede kong papuntahan, tapos gusto na nila akong kunin.
Mm-hmm.
So, kumbaga, bakit ko pa isipin? I'll just try my luck.
Yeah. Right.
Yun lang ginawa ko.
Nandun pa si Boggs.
Nandun si Boggs. Yeah, nandun lahat ng superstars.
Oh, nga. So, si Onchi. Binabati ka ni Onchi.
Ay, Onchi. Pare, musta na?
Show up dito. Mm-hmm. Pero ang galing ngayon, so there you are, suddenly they're getting you for like you said, no, the best team at that time. Right? So there was only a debate naman whether it's Toyota or Crispa, obviously, but Crispa at that time had I think more championships, di ba? And had those, and then pag sinabing all Filipino, talagang Crispa, matindi. No? Matindi. Oh, ako, may isa pa. Ito na, sunod-sunod na.
Yan na.
Binabati. Musta na?
Bye. Ha? Musta bye.
Diyan daw siya nagpa-setup ng auto. Siyempre, kanina pa. Diba? Si Bernie, thank you for watching again, Bernie.
From California.
Yeah, he said all the way in California. So wait, let's go. I think perfect na, no? Pasok na tayo sa, ano, sa segment natin. And with our first segment of this show, of our show, is called The Time Capsule. And if you give me time, I will look for the spiel that I need to say. Pasensya na, hindi tayo ready. Okay, this is brought to us by Fitbit. It helps everyone in the world get healthier. From counting your steps to giving personalized insights on your heart rate and sleep patterns, log your exercise and access great tools and content on the Fitbit Premium, all on the Fitbit platform. So check out their line of products on Fitbit.com. Feel the power. All right, pasok tayo sa una. This is a slideshow prepared by Sid Venturo. Unfortunately, cannot be with us today. Yeah. And sir, we were talking about it. There's not too many photos of you na nakakalat on the internet, and you know, and you don't have too many from your basketball career as well. But we were able to find this one. Mm-hmm. This is your rookie year, as you said, at 21. Mm-hmm. It says, no, you're endowed with a lot of promise, no. Hindi nakalagay si PFJ, is Pike F. Hoxson, di ba?
Yes.
Yeah. Si Pike Hoxson nagsulat niyan. So, sabi mo nga, you're not in a hurry. I know the star-studded team I'm with, although sometimes I wish I could be given more exposure, but coach knows best. I'm sure he knows what's good for me. I'm not complaining as in the way Coach Baby Dalupan is utilizing me. The chinky-eyed, robust-built cager with track and field thighs and legs said. Ah, di ba? Ah, malaki daw yung hita nyo, sir. Sabi ni Pike Hoxson, di ba? Di ba? So, yun yung ano. So, this is a rookie. And so since we were talking about that already, you're a rookie on this star-studded team. Did you stay also at the Crispa headquarters or the parang, di ba, meron silang dorm or di ba? Doon po kayo?
Meron na ka, at that time, may residence na kami dito sa Project Teal, sa Project 2. So, doon ako umuwi, I go home there. But sometimes, may quarters ang Crispa sa Gilmore eh.
Gilmore.
Yeah. So, pag kami like championship run, so lahat kami nandun, nire-require kami mag-quarters.
So first conference pa lang nandun ka na. Crispa PBA ka na, first conference pa lang.
Ah, oo. Oh.
Oh, kasi 5 games nga lang.
Did you miss any of those yung opening games ng Crespo nung time na yun? Kasi given that you only played you had to play in the Mika pa.
I really don't remember. I'm sorry to say.
Yeah.
Hindi ko maalala kung ano, pero parang sa tingin ko may na-miss ako.
Okay. Siguro best way to remember, were you part of the opening ceremonies in 1979?
Mm. Well, kasi lahat ng ano conference may ano, 'di ba? May opening ceremonies.
Oh.
Back then. Oh.
Back then. Yeah. Oh, may mga alam mo muses. Naman, may mga muse, may mga
yung ano. Yung muse, syempre. Oh. Yun yung hindi nakakalimutan ng mga tayo. Yung mga muse. Natatanda pa minsan. Minsan, hindi nila yung mga guests namin, hindi matandaan yung teammate nila, pero yung muse na alala nila. Diba? So, but so how was it? So you were elevated to the pro team of Crispa. Obviously, Boggs was there. What was the atmosphere for you in the first practice that you attended?
Yeah.
Well, the superstars were accommodating. Okay naman sila. Alam nilang rookie ako. Tapos, I had a good time with them. Wala naman akong naging ano. Joy Junicio was that time also a point guard of Crispa. So, lagi tawag yung bye kasi Bisaya eh. Bye.
Uh-huh.
Oh, dito ka lang bye. Akong bahala sa'yo. Mga ganun, yung mga ganun style. Then, of course, si Mr. Bernie Fabiosa na very, ano, friendly yung time na yon na pagka pareho kayong Bisaya, syempre may bond yun eh. May bond.
Uh-huh. Correct.
Nung nag-scrimmage, yung unang scrimmage nyo, sir, hindi ba kayo nasindak? Parang gagaling pala nito si Abet, si Philip, si Atoy, ganun?
Hindi naman ako nasindak. Kasi para sa akin, hindi talaga medyo may konting holding back sila pagdating sa scrimmage. Hindi talaga yung full na ano. So, at saka si Coach Dalupa noon, hindi siya ganun kabigat magpa-ensayo. So,
okay.
Tapos, scrimmage siya, kayo-kayo ganun. Tapos, tinitingnan lang niya, yung being a genius that he is, na ano, sabi ko, ganun. Pagdating sa mga drills, iba yung ma-handle ng drills namin. So, siya, pagka yung 5-on-5 na, sabi niya, ikaw, tapos dito kabila, ganun. Tapos yun na, maglalaro kayo. Tapos palalaruin lang niya kayo.
What's your biggest fondest memory or what anong tumatak sa inyo kay Coach Baby Dalupan?
Ah. Nako. Eh ito yung ano, I don't know if alam ng iba to na hindi to ganun kaganda pero tumatak talaga sa akin yung klase ng disciplinarian Coach Baby was. Okay. Si Cyrus Man, right? Cyrus Man.
Yeah.
Dumating si Cyrus Man. Pinapatakbo kami, warm up. Takbo kami. Takbo kayo 20 rounds. Takbo kayo. Ano, magpapawis lang. So takbo. Dating si Cyrus Man. Tinakbo ni Cyrus Man yan. Nakakapito pa lang kami. Tapos na si Cyrus Man. Okay. Pinilisan ni Cyrus Man. Tapos pahinga na. Eh, dumating si coach. Sabi ni coach, oh, why aren't you not running? Huh. Di siya nagrason siya. Totoo naman sabi niya, oh, I finished already. You said 20 rounds. I finished already. No. Eh, medyo nagalit siguro si coach. Gusto niya tumakbo pa. Inano niya. Sabi niya, no, you run some more. Di nag-reason out si Cyrus Man. Sabi niya, but I finish already. Nagali si coach, pinauwi.
Ah, okay.
Ganun lang. Sabi niya, go home.
Wow.
I think that was the last of him for Crispa.
Ah, okay. Yun yung last game niya.
Okay. That's a story.
Hindi ko makalimutan yun kasi nadudun ako. Sabi ko, talagang ano iba to si coach pagka ano. Hindi walang superstar pag medyo ano.
Oh, pero mali si coach doon kasi talaga binuo ni nakita niya
nabuo si talaga yung coach. Mali si coach yun. Late kasi siya umano dumating. Kami alam namin kasi talagang pag umiikot kami, nakakaisa o dalawang ikot na ino-overtake kami ni Cyrus Man.
He sprinted,
nobody spoke up for him. Like for example, an assistant coach.
Nobody. Oh, okay. Kami naman ayaw din namin ano, syempre medyo takot kami kay coach eh. Ilag kami. Kung ano, baka madamay kami. Siguro the best person there is sana yung mga may hawak ng drills, yung mga assistant coaches.
Oo, yeah, yeah.
Yung sana ang sabi, ay, hindi coach, tapos na yan. Ganun.
Yeah. Eh, kasi medyo medyo nalugi. Lugi si Cyrus doon.
Ha?
Lugi si Cyrus doon sa pangyayari
lugi,
na yun.
Lugi si Cyrus doon. Talagang ano, lugi. Yun. Yun ang medyo tumatak talaga sa akin. Eh. Hindi ko makalimutan yun.
But curiously, at that same time, medyo hindi rin maganda laro ni Cyrus din, di ba?
Yes, yes. Pababa na yung laro.
Oo. So, ano yun? Parang, was there, ano, was that part of the reason? Yung parang kaya manakas na loob ni Coach Baby na pa-uwiin siya?
I can say. Marami na kasi chismis nun kay ano eh.
Yeah.
Kay Cyrus Man eh. So, medyo mahirap magsalita. Pero, nung pumasok siya, talagang nagmamadali siya, gusto niya. Gusto niyang tapusin kagad, gusto niyang ano. Easily naman, pag player ka, pag sinabi, papawis lang kayo, 20 laps, di, bunching-bunching lang muna, di ba? Ano lang. Jogging-jogging lang. Ganon. Eh siya, tinapos niya kagad eh. Kaya na, nag-ano si coach, nag-react din si coach.
Charlie, scoop yan
eh. Oo nga, that's a scoop.
New,
right.
Something new yan.
A crazy story if you know. So I'm looking at the comments now, no? That's a great story, but a couple of comments. Number one, there's someone asking, sir, kung nagkasabay ba kayo pumasok ni Edmond Espinosa sa Crispa?
Yes, yes.
Oh, yun. So,
pareho kaming from Southwestern.
Mm-hmm.
Pareho kaming recruit.
That is confirmed.
That's also one hell of a player. Ang galing ni Ed Espinosa. Oh, ang galing. He was only like
Cebuano, Cebuano kung magdaro, no?
Oo. Pero ang tibay. Ang tibay nun.
Ganda, ganda. Good question. And then the other one, may nagme-mention nga na, Pike Hawkson mentioned it dyan sa article na yun na nakapaskil ngayon. And then Jesse Matibag said, this is the guy whose legs are comparable or bigger than Jolas pa. So, malaki daw talaga ang hita nyo. So, mataas ba kayo tumalo? Nagda-duck ba kayo? Were you a high leaper?
Ganito yan. Okay, nung nasa Mama's Lab ako, hindi naman ganun kalaki. Pero, ang players kasi nung araw, they don't put much emphasis on the upper body. Only, ano, kasi gusto talaga nila, ano, gusto talaga nila malakas lumundag. Kasi yung ano. Ngayon, when I started, 6'2 ako, naabot ko yung ring. Pero sabi ko sa sarili ko, kung gusto kong magpakita, kailangan i-improve ko yung leaping ability ko. So, umaga't hapon, iniinsayo ko, umaga't hapon, innovate ako ng weight belt, meron akong sariling ano, weight room doon sa quarters namin sa Mama's Lab. Nag-i-stairs ako. Nakikita ko yung one step sa stairs na ginagawa ko na nung araw yan eh. Yung pataas sa stairs. Tapos ano, so, after nung one year of that training, yung talagang intense na training, lumaki yung husto yung hita ko, pero lumaki din ng mga close to a foot yung talon ko.
Nice. Wow.
So, yun dun ko na ano. So, nung that time, nung Mama's Lab, nung pagpasok ko, hindi ako nakakadak. Pero nung paglabas ko, kaya ko magdak.
Mm-hmm.
So, yun through leaping ability, through improvement of, through exercise.
Right. Kumbaga, you know, kasi hindi siya inborn.
Hindi ako inborn eh. So, ano, talagang you have to work for it.
This is from the PBA annual, no? After your rookie season, I believe, after 1979 ito. The description says, the other new face in the Crispa lineup last season played center forward for Mama's Love International Pharmaceutical Inc. and Crispa in the Amateurs. Died in the wool Ateneo de Cebuanga from elementary to undergrad, transferred midstream to play for three seasons for Southwestern. hasn't played long enough in the PBA to show what it is that made Crispa think him worthy. Kasi nga, yung playing time was quite limited, no? Because of all the stars on your team.
Yes.
Pero, yun nga, you learned from them, you got to become good friends with them, including your idol, Bogs Adornado, as you mentioned. But when you first played your first game or second game in the PBA, sino ang veteranong PBA player na nag-welcome sa'yo? Na welcome to the PBA, Mr. Gulpin, sabay ginulpi ka. Gulpi. Oh. Yung unang nag-welcome sa'yo? Welcome to the PBA.
Alam mo, ano, honestly speaking, hindi ko naranasan yun eh. Kasi medyo sparingly naman ako used that time. Mm-hmm. So, siguro, if I were to be a part of the rotation, baka natanggap ko yun. Eh, siguro naawa sa aking ibang player kasi sabi ko, natin gamitin. Huwag na natin tirahin to, bira na gamitin. Just joking aside, guys.
Pero sir, ha, you went to line 6 times in 1979 and you converted all 6.
Oh, 6 of 6 from the free throw.
it's a testament of your ability to score accurately from the outside.
Kasi shooting yung ano eh, di ba? So I do my own drills, like I shoot like 700, 800 to 1,000 shots a day.
Wow.
So kaya nga nung naging close kami ni Bogs, talagang percentage wise eh, tinitingnan namin pareho yung percentage namin. So sa practice I can say I'm at par with how Bogs shoots the ball. Mm-hmm. So nasa parehong percentage kami. Pero syempre, iba naman ang game situation.
Mm-hmm. Right. And of course,
iba si Bogs Adornado.
Oh, at saka you have to be given the opportunity to play, di ba? To show what you can do, di ba?
You have to have the confidence to play and be given the right opportunity.
Correct. But we've talked about Bogs, obviously, since you were young, idol mo siya. What did you learn about the other guys on the team? Sino yung sobrang talino talaga ni Philip Cesar, sobrang grabe dumipensa si Bernie Fabiosa? Siyempre, you know all of this before you enter there. Then, was it true for you? Was everybody the kind of person you thought they would be? A kind of player?
Yeah. Philip Cesar, idol ko rin yun eh. Isa sa mga idol ko rin yun. Nung nasa Crispa na ako. So, nakikita ko siya. Si Philip, hindi masyado yung bajaging-jaging. Ayaw nung mga ganun. Si Philip, derecho, laro yun. Ano? Tapos, there was one time, dumating si Philip na parang pagod na pagod sa ensayo. UERM yun, hindi ko makalimutan. UERM yun. Tapos nagpa-ensayo na kami. Nakita namin talagang pabanjing-banjing si Ipe. Ngayon, nung 5-on-5 na, pinawisan na. I think sinubukan ko lay-upan kasi 5-on, nilay-upan ko. Wala. Nung pawisan, inabot eh. So talagang magaling talaga si sa depensa. Saludo talaga ako kay Ipe pagdating sa depensa.
That's right.
Pinawisan lang, tapos na eh.
Eh, peak pa mo din ni Philip noon, no? One-on-one champion siya na 79, tapos MVP the next year.
Yeah.
Oh, tapos pagdating ko sa ensayo, hinahamon ko yan. Hinahamon ko ng one-on-one.
Okay.
Gusto ko siya makalaro.
Okay.
Gusto ko siya makalaro. Tapos talagang, minsan siguro, pabanjing-banjing, very seldom, although very seldom, pero natatalo ko siya. Very seldom.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos, nakita ko, siniseryoso na. Nung siniseryoso na, iba na. Hindi na kaya. Pero pag hindi pa seryoso, pwede pa.
Who did you, sir, from the other team, sino yung bilib ka maglaro?
Sa other team? Okay. Oh. Aside from Arnie Tuadles, yung naging close kami kasi parehong batch kami. Tapos, sa other teams, mangha-mangha ako maglaro si Francis Arnaiz. Kasi ang hirap nung layup na ginagawa niya, yung floater na layup. Ang hirap nun. Kahit na kahit na subukan mo, malayo, te-take off ka ng halos foul throw, tapos i-ano mo, pero kontrolado niya yun. Mga kami dun.
Yeah, ako na. Bilib din ako dun kay
Kiko.
Pero it has something to do with his, ano, maganda yung take-off niya eh. Malaki, yeah. Maganda yung pag-take-off niya. So, sinasabayan niya ng, ano, meron eh, may mechanics yung shot na yun. Mm-hmm. Hindi basta ordinaryo na, ano, may mechanics siya dun sa shot na yun.
Saka alam niya pa kung paano ilawabo, kahit import ang humarap sa kanya, yeah, over the hands, di ba?
Kahit si Cyrus man eh.
Oh. 1979, All-Filipino Champions, yan. Although I'm not sure where you are there in that picture. But
I'm seated somewhere. I'm seated somewhere. Oo. So,
hindi ko yun yung katabi ni Joy Junish. Oh, medyo blurred yung nakuha natin eh. Pero oh, yeah. that's the best we could get.
Hindi ba yung katabi ni Atoy sa taas? Sa right ni Atoy?
Pwede rin.
Masa. Ano lang? Oh, very ano, may glare lang talaga, but oh, the only one very very clear there is Abet, Bernie in the front, and then si Bones. Philip. And of course Tito Barella, you cannot miss
Tito Barella. Oh. Tito is a very nice guy, ah. Tito is a very nice guy.
Yeah. Sobra. Yeah. Okay Advice. Din yan, yung nag-guest din. Yun, tabi ni Atoy daw, sabi ni Bernie. Mm-hmm. Si Mr. Phil nasa tabi ni Atoy daw.
Pero sir, ang balik lang ako doon sa rookie ano mo no noong 79. So, 'di ba, sa pasok kay sa CRISPA. Pero alam niyo naman na siguro na superstar studded na yung CRISPA noong time na 'yon. How hindi ba kayo ano nag-alangan na parang sandali mabibigyan ba ako ng playing time dito considering that nung 1977 saka nang 1978 nung nagpasok ng rookies din ng CRISPA, hindi masyado nabigyan ng playing time.
Aware ako noon. Pero sa akin, I will try my luck. Kumbaga, susubukan ko na lang kung saan ako dadalhin. Kung hindi man ako maging successful, all I can say is I played for the, at that time, the best, if not one of the best teams in PBA. So, wala akong sentiments na hindi ako nabigyan ng playing time. Wala akong qualms about it. I'm okay.
Yeah. So, 2 years nga, two seasons ka doon. Do you have a most memorable game?
Well, I had a game, I think, in Davao, na out-of-town game, na sinabihan ako ni coach na, oh, gagamitin kita. So, sinabihan talaga ako ni coach. So, naghanda ako. Siguro, I scored, hindi naman umabot ng double figures. Pero naka-score ako ng konti. So, isa yun sa mga memorable kasi siguro I was able to play like maybe close to 20 minutes that game.
So, medyo ano na yun. Marami na yun, no?
Oo, talagang napakalaki na nun.
So, sa rotation, sinong ano mo? Kay Hubaldi ka ba o kay ano kay Philip?
So, kay Freddy ako sumusunod. Mm-hmm. Marami pa yun. Minsan, nagpapalitan sila ni Atoy. Yeah. Minsan, kasi, although yung point guard noon that time, si Bernie, tapos si Joy, tapos yung mga off-guard noon, yun, sila Atoy, sila Freddy, tapos si Jimmy Javier, was also playing that time, GB Javier.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Ano yun? Oh, so, yun ang medyo center siya that time. Nasa mga ano na eh, third, if not fourth na ako sa, dun sa pwesto na yun. So, talagang sparingly lang talaga yung ano, yung paggamit.
Correct.
Yeah, but then you did nga win. You were part of two championship teams, no? So, first conference of the 79 and then this third one. Conference ng 1980, diba? Itong,
which was the impressive run, ha? Yung 1980 na yan.
Yung 1980, yan ba yung ano? Supposedly unprecedented na ano?
Yes, 19-0.
Tapos 19-0, tapos Royal True Orange ang kalaban. Tama ba?
Ano kayo, tapos kalaban nyo? Yung 19-0 kayo, tapos yung si Jaworski at si Acuna na nagka-problema sa finals.
Oo. Oh. yung pala yun.
Yung 1980. Mm-hmm. Diba? So, pero grabe nga.
Oh. Tanong ko lang kung sino vote na sa ano, isang, may hindi ako ma-identify dito eh. Sino yung katabi ni Atoy at saka yung katabi ng Atoy? Yung nakaganon na nakahawak sa trophy.
Yung the man na nakaganon?
Yeah. Ah, yun. Yung ganon.
With at the striped shirt. Oh,
si Amado Recio ba yung isa?
Oo. Oh. Si Amado yun.
Okay. Tapos yung nakaganon na nakaganyan.
Parang ano yan eh. Hindi ko na. Kalimutan ko na yung pangalan niya eh. Pero so, very... Oo. Parang lagi siya nandyan. Lagi siya nandyan sa team.
Yeah, may ganun. Most of the teams have that. Uy, anong nangyari? What happened? Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Mang Doji Ramos daw, sabi ni Bernie Faust.
Thank you.
Doji, Doggy, Ramos.
Ang talas niya, no? Ang talas
pa ng
memory niya.
Alam ni Kuya Burns. Doddy Ramos daw. Doddy Ramos. Dama, hindi Doddy Ramos. Iba yun. Ibang player yun.
Ah, player din yun. Player yun. Nag-guess
na rin sa amin si Doddy. Based in Australia. But Doddy Ramos daw yung guy na yan. Okay.
Okay.
Alright. And then, okay, so great. Let's go to the next photo, Carly. Let's check it out. So that's the one championship. Fortunately, I don't know if we were able to find. This is the second one? Or yeah, the, is it the same? Ito 1980, di ba? Ito yung 1980 championship, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Mama Rills there na eh, di ba?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Di ba? So, pangalawa na yata ito. Andyan ka, nakayakap ka kay Philip.
Mm-hmm.
Beside Tito Varela. Tito. Sino nasa kanan ni Philip?
Nasa kanan ni Philip.
Oh, yung medyo hidden yung face, may bigote. On the right, on the bottom left corner of the photo. Who's that?
Tanong na kaya natin si Mr. Bernie.
Oh, nga, baka alam niya. Joy Jonicio, Bernie Fabiosa. On the right side, that's...
Bong de la Cruz.
No, Bong de la Cruz is the one on the right. Yeah?
Oh, Bong de la Cruz is the one on the right.
Oh, the right, yeah. On the other side.
Hindi ba si Frank Natividad yan?
Frank Natividad, maybe?
Uh-huh.
Pwede si Frank.
Uh-huh. Then the guys on top, Jamie Javier, Romy Mamaril, Gidabin, Hubalde Ko, Coach Baby, and then the rest, hindi ko nakilala, Danny Floro, of course.
Sir, may Danny Floro story kayo?
Wala masyado, pero all I can say about the person, about Mr. Danny Floro is, talagang napakabait niya sa mga players. Napakabait niya. At saka talagang he will see to it na kung may kailangan ka, bata, may kailangan ka, sabihin mo lang sa akin anong kailangan mo. Andito, kung anong ano. Marami nga, pati ano, kailangan mo bang matitirhan o kailangan mo ng ganito, ganun. So, kumpleto si manager Danny Floro.
Ito may minention na name si Bernie, June Nato.
Ah, June Nato.
And then sabi, then James T says it's Ed Espinosa beside Cesar?
Hindi. Parang hindi.
Medyo darker kasi si Ed.
Okay.
Si Ed Espinosa yung katabi Jimmy Javier, di ba? Yung nasa pinaka-right, nakatayo.
Oh, yun. Oh, katabi. Yan. Katabi ni, katabi ni Jimmy up here.
I'm having trouble identifying these guys, but this is a clearer picture now. Hindi kasi blurred nung isa.
Sino si June Nato? Yun ang gusto ko malaman. Ano siya? Utility or ano?
Si June Nato, I think, is laging kasama ni manager. Laging kasama ni manager. Si June Nato, I think, is not included as a staff, pero nandiyan siya pagka kasama si manager.
Okay.
Yun ang, ewan ko lang, i-confirm natin kay Mr. Fabiosa.
So there was a measure of success naman, even if you didn't get to play too much during your 2 years, 2 championships naman yan. And I guess, bumiyahe ba kayo, sir? May mga biyahe kayo after that?
Meron kami. Yung dalawang biyahe na yon, di pumunta kami Hong Kong, pumunta kami ng Taiwan. Tapos, eto nga mahilig na ako sa kotse noon. So, nung pauyan kami, pinagtatawan ako nila Atoy. Sabi niya, anong dala mo? Magwheels. Magwheels ang dala ko. Yeah. Umuwi ako ng Magwheels. Sabi niya, ano ba yan? Bakit yan ang inuwi mo? Lo and behold, after ano a year or two, sila din nagdadala ng Magwheels.
Ginaya ka na.
Anong coach niyo yun, sir?
It's a Toyota Corolla SR. Yeah.
Corolla SR. Pili ka talaga sa kotse.
Yung kotse ko, Corolla SR.
Yeah. Hindi ba naging issue yan, sir?
Hindi naman. Ay,
Toyota gamit yan.
Wala namang crisp na sasakyan, so, di ba? Pwede naman siguro mag Toyota. Damit. And so, but, since you mentioned that already, and you know, obviously we'll get into that more later, when did your interest in cars, you know, when did it happen? When you were still young or nag-Manila ka na sa Cebu?
When I was in Cebu, I had a best friend who was also my teammate in Mama's Club and Cebu Southwestern, the late Freddy Serafica. I don't know if you know. He's the first cousin of Steve Watson, Alfredo Serafica.
Yeah,
the name many times.
Medyo ano siya? They're well off, kasi so niyaya niya. Dito ka matulog sa bahay. So natutulog, and dami niyang magazines, car magazines. Tapos lagi niya sasabi, tiyan mo to, Philo, ito, ganito to. So doon ako nagkaroon ng, ano, ng interest. Although hindi niya alam. Pero I was looking forward na pagtutunan, Fred, nasa na yung mga magazines mo? Oh, nandito, nandiyan, dami niya. So lagi akong ano. Tapos nung nagkaroon ako ng kotse, pwede palang palitan ng makina.
Mm-hmm.
So pwedeng palitan ng makina. So I ended up nung nasa Crispa na ako, pinapalitan ko yung makina. Actually sa Cebu pa ako pala pinapalitan ko na yung makina. Tapos nung nasa ano, pinalitan ko rin na mas malakas. Yung ganun.
So kinargahan mo na.
Oo, tapos unti-unti karga. Yun doon na nabaling yung ano ko. Yung passion ko, parang ganun.
Yeah, so playing
pa ako for Crispa, ano na ako, sabi nga ni Coach Baby, hindi ko makalimutan, sabi niya, si Phil Gulpin, buti pa yung kotse, tulin-tulin. Sabi sa, ano. so yun ang ano. At that time noon, sila Atoy, sila Freddy, puro mga Celestian. Yeah. Galant, yung mga ganon. Si Bernie Celestian, si Abet Galant yun, si Philip Cesar, Sigma yata yung auto. Parang ganon, puro Mitsubishi. Tapos ako lang yung Toyota.
Ayaw nila ng Toyota. Ganon nila kaayaw yung Toyota.
Oo.
Pati kotse ayaw
nila. Hindi nila masabi sa akin yun, pero ganon nila kaayaw yung Toyota.
Si Bernie, ano kotse nun?
Celeste.
Yeah. I mentioned rin yata niya, no, when we were when we had him on the show. So just you're getting into that, and then actually someone mentioned to me, I'm trying to remember if it's Cho season, that you would check out their cars. Pinapa-check nila yung mga kotse daw nila sa iyo after practice or something. You would be the one to look. So talagang pati makina na pag-aralan mo na, you know, it wasn't just yung forma, pero pati yung pagtakbo ng sasakyan, pinag-aralan mo na, alam mo na.
Oo, through experience na, kasi I started building race engines na nung ano. So nung nag-umpisa ako naging naging serious, sabi ko, nakita ko na pwede kong gawing plan B ito, just in case if hindi gumana yung basketball ko.
Yeah.
So yun ang medyo unti-unti yung passion ko na hindi na ganun kabuo sa basketball, na na-shift na unti-unti.
Right. So the shifting. But speaking of shifting, so you did play the two successful seasons with Crispa. And then you asked to transfer, no? To another team.
I asked to transfer. Kung pwede, nagpaalam ako. Kasi para sa akin, isa yun sa pinaka-importante na hindi ka dapat you should always ask for the permission na kung pwede mong gawin ito.
Mm-hmm.
Like, syempre, si Coach Baby o ano, the same thing what I did with Mama's Lab when I transferred to Manila. I went back home to Mama's Lab and asked for their blessings if I can go and play in Manila.
Oh.
Eh, karamihan kasi lumilipad na lang. Naglalaro kami, biglang nababasa namin. Oh, si B-Boy, nasa Romago na. Hindi namin alam. Yeah. Oh, yeah, so, yeah. Yun ang mga ano. So, I made it a point na babalikan ko, magpapaalam ako ng maayos para may blessings ako from.
Yeah, yeah. Para clean break, di ba?
Yes, yes. Anytime. Ngayon, babalik ako sa kanila, dinadalo ko sila. Wala akong problema, wala silang masabi, wala rin ako masabi.
Pero bakit napili mo itong ano CFC Great Taste, which is actually Presto Fun Drink?
Kasi nakausap ko si IG, Ignacio Gotaw.
Yeah, okay.
Ignacio Gotaw used to be the manager of ano Presto.
Correct.
So, Bisaya din yun. Sabi ko, sir, baka pwede ako maglaro dyan. So, ako mismo lumapit sa kanya. Sabi niya, oh, sige, gusto mo maglaro dito sa amin? Sige, tingnan natin kung paano. Bisaya kami. So, nagawa niya, sige, dito, lipat ka na dito sa amin. Ganun lang kadali nung araw.
Kadali, ano?
So,
and was it a two-year contract right away?
It was a three-year contract.
Oh, three, actually. Okay. But this is after the 82 season, I believe, no?
Yung 83 yes, dapat yes. Ang third season ko, Ricky Brown was already here. I met Ricky Brown.
Okay.
Pero hindi na ako nakapaglaro noon.
Yeah.
So I opted na, sabi ko kay manager IG Gotaw, sabi ko, sir, parang ayoko na maglaro. So okay. Paano yung ano, baka kailangan yung slot ko. So sabi niya, pwede bang mag-uusap tayo? Sabi niya, sige, mag-uusap tayo tungkol dun sa mga tatanggapin mo on this third year. So naayos namin yon.
Yeah. Tapos so all good.
All good.
So na-pastor talagang ano ka na, you decided it's time to stop. Not just stop playing for Great Taste, but stop playing altogether at the age of what, 25?
Yeah, age of 25.
Bakit? Kasi ano nag full shift na talaga yung interest mo.
Oo, I was
coaching na talaga.
I was like doing one engine a week.
Oh, ganun na eh. Okay.
One engine a week. So, medyo nakilala na ako sa field ng ano, illegal drug racing pa yun noon, Green Hills.
Yeah. Green Hills, oh, yeah. Oh, alam ni Jay yan. Alam parang ni Jay yan.
Oh, nung pumupunta yung mga tao nagpapagawa. So nakita ko yung business side of it. Tapos nakita ko yung passion ko na uy, may passion pala akong gawin to. Kasi ako mismo nag-tune, ako mismo nagte-test ng mga
auto. Yeah.
So yun.
And you're racing, you fix your own car and you get into the driver's seat, ikaw na rin nagpapatakbo.
Oo. Oh, We have some drivers also like a good friend of mine, Mio Bolaños. He also drives, sabay kami nag-ano. So, yun ang ano, I do the engine, then I tune, then I race.
Yeah. Well, this is all we could find from your Great Taste days. Wala tayong photo na nahanap of you, but this is the lineup of that team in 1981. Ronnie Albor, Joel Banala, former guest, Bien de la Cruz, si Chong Marquez, Woodrow, Haimali, Eddie Boy Mendoza, former guest, Leo Paguntalan, Retualo, Jose Roslin, a name that I've had forgotten and
Stepan
I saw it.
Roslin, yeah, I don't know. Oh. And Haimalin. Haimalin is there. Haimalin.
Yes. Yeah, Woodrow Haimalin. Tapos yung dalawa sa dulo, naging guest din natin, Cho Season, Manny Victorino, and of course, Coach Jimmy Mariano has also been on our show, no? So yan ang lineup niyo that year. Did you get to play more with Great Taste than you did with Chris Patrick?
A little more. Pero nung nasa Great Taste kasi ako, medyo my basketball took a backseat na eh. Hindi na ako ganun ka ano, basta minsan pagka nagse-set up ako, naggagawa ako, biglang isipin ko, uy, 30 minutes na may practice, tatakbo pa ako, di ba? Kumbaga, hindi na yung focus ko, hindi na ganun.
Correct.
Pero still, syempre gusto ko, pero yung passion ko slowly nag-shift na dun sa isang ano.
How did Coach Jimmy Mariano utilize you? Ang Jim, anong difference ng paggamit ni Baby Dalupan sa inyo compared sa kay Jimmy Mariano?
Very similar din, very similar. Mm-hmm. Oo, hindi rin okay din, parang player's coach din si Coach Jimmy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Hindi rin siya masyado ano o konti lang salita ganun. Mm-hmm. Mas ano si Coach Baby, konti lang salita eh minsan mura pa. Mm-hmm.
old school talaga 'yon.
Old school talaga, old school. That time, wala. Normal 'yon eh.
Yeah, yeah. So, just wanted to mention, no, si Mr. Bebot Valles, one of our followers watching, just wants to inform you that his friend Steve Akayan was his former office mate in Petron Corporation.
Yes.
Steve Akayan.
Okay. Yeah, so just Steve mentioning Akayan. Oh, I also did some engines for Paeng Nodalo. Paeng Nodalo.
Oh, yeah.
Owner of Nodalos. Tapos yeah, si Steve Akayan is the navigator of Paeng Nodalo.
Oh, yeah. So that's the connection. Okay.
That's the connection. Yeah, that's the
connection. So you walked away, no? You walked away from basketball after playing four seasons and then you concentrated on motorsports already after that, yes, no? So, pero okay ka na. At peace ka nun. At 25 years old, you're at peace to walk away from basketball.
Yes, I was at peace.
Walang problema talaga. Okay. So that's I think that's the first half of our time capsule, di ba? And so we take this opportunity to remind everyone we are part of the Globally Ballin Network. Check us out on the Spotify channel of Globally Ballin. We are there. Give us some love. Rate us with a 5-star rating, please. And then you can become our monthly supporter by sending us just $4.99 or 250 pesos. We're also fixing it to make sure that there's that button. Maka may nagreklamo sa akin na walang button daw for that, but we'll get that fixed as soon as we can become our monthly supporter. We love you forever. Globally Ballin Southeast Asia on Facebook page. Please follow that for tidbits of all the shows on the Globally Ballin Network. So we're back to Time Capsule, which is brought to us by Fitbit. It helps everyone in the world get healthier from counting your steps to giving personalized insights on your heart rate and sleep patterns. So log your exercise and access great tools and content on the Fitbit Premium, all on the Fitbit platform. So check out the line of products on Fitbit.com. Feel the power. Pasok tayo. Since we have made the shift, this is the shift already. Ayan na, motorsports na nga ang naging passion ni Mr. Phil Gulfin. And nag-mention na nga ng mga comments na you would look at their cars, that became your passion. But before we delve into that, Jay wants to ask you something about CRISPA. Go.
Kasi gusto ko lang, anyway, James T. also asked this question earlier. No? Let's talk about the 1980 All-Filipino Conference Finals. Yun yung naka 19-0 record kayo, and then on your 20th, your last game supposedly na masisweep ninyo yung conference, may nangyari sa Toyota, no? When that happened and you lost that game, what were the words that that came out from the coaching staff ng CRISPA noong time na yun after you hindi nyo na-meet yung record?
Hindi masyado nagsalita si Coach Baby to what I remember. Hindi masyado nagsalita. Kasi sabi niya, bawi na lang tayo. Ganun lang kasimple. Hindi natin ginawa to o hindi natin ginawa yon. Mm-hmm. Pero ano lang siya, few words lang. Mm-hmm. Tapos bawi tayo.
Was there a bonus that was promised to you if you go 20-0?
Yes, there was.
Meron talaga. Mm, nabigay meron pa rin ba or partial na lang because you ended up with 20-1?
Tingin ko hindi nabigyan.
Okay.
Oh, tingin ko lang, I can be wrong kasi mahirap na 'yan. Pero I think hindi nabigyan kasi actually hindi rin naman talaga namin natupad 'yun eh.
Mm-hmm.
So pero all I can say with our manager is very generous when it comes to bonuses.
Of course.
Oo.
Nice.
Oh, yan. Sige. I had to get that out of the way lang, Charlie. Sige, go.
So, diretso na tayo sa ano, tell us about your career in motorsports. So, it spanned a long time, and as we mentioned earlier, so many people remember you as a motorsports guy and don't remember so much your basketball career anymore. Kumbaga na, na-oversado na eh. No? So, your rise, tell us about your story. So, you started fixing cars, racing in Green Hills, and eventually, you're racing in the actual racetracks already. Anong kwento doon, sir?
Okay. So from 1981 till about 1985 nagkaroon na ng legal 1986 nagkaroon ng legal drag race. Sumali ako na medyo maganda yung resulta. Tapos tuloy-tuloy then na-expose din ako sa rally kasi guys like VP Sada, Mandy Duque, mga famous rally drivers natin, I did their engine. So when I did their engine, we went to Malaysia to join the Rally of Malaysia. It's a once in a year international. So I was with them as their tuner, as their engine builder. So yun yung mga ano ko. Okay. Then 1989, I went into slalom. So nag-try ako mag-slalom. Nakuha ko yung championship sa novice. Yun lang naman kasi habol ko, yung novice championship. So nakuha ko. Tapos 1990, I went into rally. Yun din ang habol ko. Novice championship, nakuha ko yun. So from then on, 1990-1991, masyado nagiging mahirap yung illegal drag racing dito sa Pilipinas. Kasi hinuhuli ng police to a point na minsan ako na experience ko natutukan ako ng long firearm because of
wow.
Just being there. Now sabi ko kailangan may mangyari dito. So that's how I started with informing all the racing groups to join forces to go for the bid to have this legal. So I founded the Philippine Drag Racers Federation. Ako nag-start.
I see. So that's the story. Okay.
That's the story. Tapos yun, pagkatapos noon, I went into officiating. Nag-officiate ako. I was the scrutineer. Scrutineer in a motorsport is hard. Kasi syempre maraming sinasabi sila na hindi naman nila ginagawa pero nagawa nila. So I'm sure you guys know what I mean. Na so yung as a job of a scrutineer, you have to prove to them na mali yung ginawa nila, na kung may reprimand sila, may penalty sila or may disqualification sila, akong gagawa nun. So
Sige, go on, sir. Go on.
So yun ang ano ko, pero hindi ako nagkaroon ng kaaway ng dun sa part na yun. Kasi lahat ng scrutineer nahihirapan sila, ayaw nila yung job na yun eh. Ako I embrace it kasi para sa akin it's how you communicate with the competitors and it's how you make them realize na what they did was wrong. Pero hindi mo dapat sila i-put down, hindi mo sila dapat sabihan na bakit mo ginawa to or bakit. You act as if like maybe they don't know what they did and it was wrong. So you just inform
them. Para may presumption na hindi nila sinadya. Hindi nila sinadya.
Okay. So ganun ang style ko. So hindi ako nagka-problema sa nice. Being a scrutineer until lately. I still do it from time to time.
Sir, I understand this is an expensive hobby, but is it also a lucrative business on your end?
For me, not really that lucrative, but since I do engines for other people also, I consider it a business of some sort. So pero you have to show them what you are capable of doing.
Yeah.
So before if you have good results, kahit na hindi ka magsalita, pupunta sila sa iyo eh. Kasi alam nila kung anong kaya mo.
Word of
mouth. So ganun ang nakasanayan ko.
Who were your big time clients aside from Paengo Dado, of course, and VP Sada and Mandy Duque? Sino pa yung naging big time clients ko?
Maraming mayayaman. Oo. Medyo hindi ko na ano. And diyan ko rin nga na ano eh, na-meet si RSA. Si RSA, na-meet ko yan. Naging good friend ko si RSA through motorsports.
Pero so, si Ramon Ang, no? For yeah, those who are si not Ramon aware of the issues.
Din, passion din talaga niya yung motorsports.
Sinado talaga yan.
Oo.
Medyo... Sina Ricky Dilyaco, did you get to work with them before?
Yeah, yeah. I did engine for the Ricky, slalom days. Tapos, ano, and do you know his position now is the, ano, ma motorsport in charge for AAP. Natasin question niya ni Ricky ngayon. And he still does officiating out of the country.
Galing. Okay.
He's a good friend. He's a good friend.
You sent me some footage though, of what you said was your last race. So you don't get behind the wheel anymore now, sir?
Well, that series is Classic Aspirated Cup. I also founded it. I also started it.
Mm-hmm.
So it started 2015. Then I joined. Then come 2017 to 2019, I got the championship. Mm-hmm. So now, sabi ko, ano, okay na ako dun eh. Okay na ako dun. So, hindi na ako kailangan na taon-taon, i-ano ko. Kasi may risk. Mataas yung risk factor dun.
Yeah.
It's very dangerous. Although kami, yung class na yun, dun mo lang makikita na meron age limit dun. You have to be 36 years old and above to join that race.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Kasi yung para sa akin, yun ang nag-identify dun sa era na yun eh. Dun sa era na yun. So yung old school, carburetor, mga ano namin, wala pang fuel injection, walang turbo, walang supercharge, yung mga ganun.
Yeah.
It's all motor. Parang ganun.
Mm-hmm. There's a good question from James na si Dante Silverio ba nakasama mo rito sa motorsports?
Nakaano si Dante nung ano nung nagra-rally siya. And of course, his son Jojo. Merong ngang ano si Dante kasi si Dante is a very easy to get along with guy.
Oh yes.
Sabi nga niya, kahit na ano ako noon, wala na ako sa basketball noon. Sabi niya, kung gusto mo mag further study sa Japan, sa Toyota, sabi mo sa akin, i-recommenda kita. So, sinabi niya sa akin ni Dante yun. Sabi ko, sige sir, pagka, ano, sabihan ko kayo. Pero hindi na nangyari yun. So, yun. Pero he's a very likable guy.
Yes. Mm-hmm. At 85 years old, can still,
can still sing and dance all night.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's a groove.
Yeah. Toyota reunion, talagang wow. Siya, on all cylinders siya. Yung ibang mga players niyan, pumapalya na. Di ba? Oh. Pero siya talagang boom! Di ba? Talagang humahapa pa rin. Arangkada pa rin. So, di ba? So, what's the next photo, Carly? Let's check it out. I think this is all from the motorsports part of Mr. Gulfin's life already. Ito, Starlet yan, ano? Yan ba yung Starlet?
Yes.
Casino.
Starlet yan. Maliit.
Casino Active.
Sponsor.
Ikaw nag-assemble lahat yan. You're the one who put the engine together. No?
Galing.
I guess once you get into it, it's hard to get out na. No? But do you still play basketball? Because I do understand, I did see some photos from more recent years. There's a photo, I don't think we're going to show it, but I saw it. You're with Epoy Halmasco in something. You're about to play a game or something like that. So nakakalaro ka pa rin. Hindi naman talaga nawala ang basketball sa buhay.
Hindi naman talaga. Like, twice a week, dun sa Project 2, maraming court kasi dun eh. So, kilala na ako ng mga bata. So, nakikipaglaro pa rin ako. Pero ngayon, medyo mas seldom na.
Yeah.
Mas seldom na.
And are you still in touch with your former teammates, sir?
Sad to say.
Not so much. Sa December, sir, pag matutuloy po yung reunion ng Crispa Toyota, andun kayo dapat.
I would like to.
Oh yeah, you're sigurado kasama ka dun, sir. We'll let you know all the details. Jay Mercado is one of the organizers, so we will make sure you'll be there.
Ah, okay.
Count
me in.
Opo. Sir, saan po itong ano na to? Itong picture na to? Saan ginawa to?
Sa ano yan? Sa Tagaytay yan. Kasi may property ako sa Tagaytay. Okay. So yan, pag nakita mo, ano yan eh, kakaputok lang nung Taal Volcano. Kaya yung daan niya, puro lahar yan. puro lahat.
Well, where are most of the races, the races like that, the footage you sent me, sir, that unfortunately we're not able to show it, but san ginawa yung
race? Sa Batangas na Racing Circuit yon.
Ah, doon. Okay, yes.
Barangay Maligaya, yes, Rosario, yes. Batangas.
Yeah, yeah. Heading to ano, Laia. May kita mo yan.
Very popular, yes. Yan.
I just saw it a couple of weeks ago. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, doon pala talaga yon. Okay. So, and then, okay. Let's look at the next one. Alam ko, puro ano to eh. Puro sa motorsports na yung mga photo of na hinanda ni Sid. Well, there's you in action. There is you in action. Diba?
Omega Pro.
Yung mga ganyan, walang ano, no? It's just one person in the car, no? Walang kasama yan, ano?
Wala, oo. Pagka yung may navigator, rally yun.
I see, okay. Yeah. So, paano kayo nagkasya sa Starlet? E 6'2 kayo?
Ay! Alam mo, kailangan tabasin yung ano, di ba may parang ano ng kaha? May umbok ng kaha yan sa may flooring.
Yeah.
Kailangan tabasan mo yon para may iupo mo yung bucket seat na sagad sa flooring. Tapos atras na atras.
Okay.
Okay ako dyan, maluwag ako dyan. Pero nung ano, parang hindi proportionate sa akin, no? Laki-laki ko tapos nandito. Oh,
sa wala ng kasya sa likod mo.
Wala na.
Diba? Sagad na yan eh. Oo.
Diba? Sa haba ng binti niyo.
Galing. I believe we have one last photo after this. Let's look at it already. Kasi yun na yun eh. Ito, yeah. The big guns of Philippine motorsports, and among them is Mr. Phil Gulpin. It's on the right side. Dami mga bata rito. Who are these children, sir?
Meron dyan sa karting galing, tapos okay. Motocross. Kasi lahat ng motorsports yan eh. So, meron dyan sa slalom, meron sa rally, meron sa karting, meron sa 4x4. Meron sa slalom. So lahat yan, yun sa akin, yung classic aspirated, yun yun. Mm-hmm.
Classic yun, aspirated, okay.
13 yeah. coveted trophies in one picture, sabi.
Who are
different
the four,
sizes, no? Age and sizes.
Yeah. Who are the four senior guys, sir? The five senior guys, doon sa, from standing from the left.
Standing from the left.
Yes,
yeah, kilala mo ba lahat yan, sir?
RJ De Guzman.
Okay.
I'm not so familiar with the 4x4 guy.
Okay.
Tapos, yung medyo, malaki siya na medyo gray hair si June Magno. Sa rally yun.
Okay.
Sa rally.
Okay.
Oh, June Magno. Tapos, yung mga iba, yung mga bata eh.
No, yeah. Oh, I would imagine, baka di mo na.
Doon lang kami nagkakilala.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, siyempre, you stand head and shoulders above everybody else.
Of course.
Kau yung pinakamalaki talaga, kitang-kita. And as I mentioned earlier, and we did show it on the screen, no? Philippine motorsports icon na nga si Mr. Gulfin. And you know, you're still involved in that. I'm pretty sure, you know, as the years go on, you're still, if you pull away from that, you're still gonna be an advisor somehow. You're still gonna be involved in that. Kasi maraming pupunta sa iyo, no, for advice on their cars, I suppose, no?
I still do it. I still do engines on the side, but on a limited basis. Mm-hmm. Tapos officiating, nandiyan pa rin ako. Pagka drag racing kasi, nandiyan ako to help them officiate.
Right.
Sir, when you say on a limited basis, what does that mean?
Hindi na kagaya noon, like pagka tumanggap ako, mahaba yung timeline.
Okay.
Yung mga ganon. So
kung
hindi
kami
na yung
ni Charlie, pwede kami magpagawa sa inyo, tatanggapin ninyo.
Ah, oo.
Nice yan. But that's great. So, I mean, this is great information for people for the guys who are watching and you know, for exactly. Anybody who wants to know about it. I mean, this is a tale of two stories. Diba? This exactly. Is double tale ito eh. Diba? Kasi there's the basketball career and then there's the motorsports career, which, you know, really for a short while medyo nag-overlap sandaling, but then when you walked away, you know, you went that direction for motorsports. It's very impressive. But 25 years old, no? Grabe, no? You gave up the playing career for that. That's wow. Andun ka na. Pero wala eh. The passion leads you to where you want to go, I suppose, no? That's how it is. And now you have, sige, sir.
I can comment that I think I'm the only one who made a nice transition from basketball to motorsport.
For sure.
Yun lang yung tapos yung passion na yun.
Yeah.
I see some guys like Hector sometimes because right. Hector is the father of Andres. Andres mm-hmm. is racing, Andres Calma. Mm-hmm. So nakikita ko lang siya doon as a spectator sa mga race track.
I was going to ask niya, wala bang ibang na players na pumasok sa motorsports kahit sandali, wanted to race, wanted, you know, wala?
Wala. Kasi, kung active ka pa, medyo, hindi ka dapat sumali kasi medyo delikado.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Baka ma-end yung career mo.
So after siguro sa basketball playing career, siguro pwede. Pero sa mga nakikita ko noon, may passion. Isa sa Toyota, if you remember, Nick Bulaong. Nick
Bulaong. Of course. Okay.
Nick Bulaong, we shared the same passion.
Okay.
So he was a Toyota. Ganun din yung kotse niya, Corolla SR din. We shared the same passion. Pero nung umalis si Nick nag-abroad si Nick. I don't know. I hope he's doing okay.
Oh, we haven't had the chance to have him on the show yet. Hopefully we get him kasi siya na lang yung isa sa mga Toyota guys that we haven't gotten. No?
Mm-hmm.
So if anybody has any leads to Nick Bulaong, please let us know. Send us a DM on our Facebook page. That would really be great.
Kahit na lang halos si Nick di ba? 1967 din yata si Nick
Ito tanong ni Ronald Mariano. Sinong player merong pinaka-mean na setup?
Yeah.
si Freddy. Si Freddy nagkaroon ng Celica tapos kompletong 2TG. 2TG yung engine na Toyota. Isa 2 liter. Tapos ang medyo nung ang kumarera pa ng player si Onchi after his playing career.
Onchi
De La Cruz. Nagkaroon ng owner yan si Onchi na highly modified talaga yung engine niya. So sumali din sa mga illegal yan.
Kaya nga ako nagtataka kasi I really see basketball players as guys who like nice cars, talaga fast cars. Nobody followed in your footsteps, no? So parang ikaw lang talaga yung humita. But anyway, I guess pang-forma lang siguro.
Ngayon yata Charlie Motocross, mahilig yata sila James Yap, di ba? If I'm not mistaken.
I know nagbi-big bike sila. I don't know about kung motocross, pero nagbi-big bike, they bike around, no? Yeah, there's that bikers club now of the PBA, ex-PBA guys, but mostly of the younger ones already.
Yeah.
Diba sila Rico, sila JJ, Enrico, diba that bunch. Pero yung sa auto, wala masyado. Pero galing ha. I mean, this has really been a great episode. Sir, ang ganda ng kwentuhan natin about the basketball aspect and of course the motorsports. And I'm sure you could talk about motorsports for another 3 hours. Walang problema sa iyo.
Maybe another week.
This is an eternity of basketball, though. So,
you should be invited sa show ni Lindy at saka ni Robert, si Potenciano.
Mike
Potenciano.
Have you been on that show? Did they ever interview you on that show? They used to have one. I don't know if it's still ongoing, but motorsports focused yun, di ba?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Motorsports focused yun. Yeah, that's right. Galing ng mga kwento. Jay, pahabol.
Siguro. You sabi nga niya, tale of two stories. Do we see a third story?
Yeah, what's in store?
A third story might just be enjoy life.
Mm-hmm.
Ganun lang. Be a grandfather. So, mm-hmm. medyo ease up on, be contented para sa akin.
Yeah. Ilan na po ba ang apo nila?
Isa lang.
Isa pa lang. Okay.
Isa lang. Isa lang kasi yung daughter ko eh.
Mm-hmm.
So, isa.
I met the other day. I met her the other day. Thanks nga pala for helping set up this, her father, no? Si Mr. Phil dito sa ating show. Maraming salamat kay Estelle.
Kanya tong gamit na to. So, salamat din sa kanya.
I did the test with her the other day, no? So, very good. Maraming salamat sa kanya, sa tulong niya. Galing.
Is a guy or a boy or girl?
Which one?
Yung apo po ninyo.
Girl.
Oh. So, granddaughter, naku. Spoiled kay Lolo yan, sigurado.
Yeah, man.
Ganun pala. Ganun talaga yan, ha? Di ba? Yung mga babae, love na love na mga lolo yan. Anyway, but that's great. So yeah, you're right, no? Eventually, hopefully, we can all get there to just be content with life and enjoy what we've achieved and what we've gotten, di ba? Abot din tayo dyan. Pero great, what a great hour and a half it's been with Mr. Phil Golfin. Love the stories. Love the Cyrus Man story. Kawawa naman si Cyrus, the late Cyrus Man.
Ano na ba?
So he passed away last year. He passed away last year. So early last year, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, Noel broke the news, actually. It was Noel who,
kami nag-break the news. Yeah. We were trying to get in touch with him. The brother was in touch with our Noel Zarate. And then the brothers, di pa namin ma-convince. Then he messaged to say that Cyrus had passed away. So, di ba? Okay, yung mga humihingi ng interview kay Don, RIP talaga. Nag-uusap na sila noon, i-explain na niya kay Coach na talagang nabuo niya yung 20 rounds bago tumating si Coach. So, nag-uusap sila doon ngayon. Di ba? Sana na-explain na at pinagbigyan na siya ni Coach Baby. Anyway, so you know, some people are asking for Don Ampalayo, another Cebuano, to come on the show. Well, he has declined our invitation, so hopefully we can convince him. But anyway, so that's a great hour and a half. But we do have our regular segments on this show. So that was Time Capsule. We're done with that. That was brought to us by Fitbit. Let's enter the Twilight Zone now as we enter towards the end of our show. The Twilight Zone, of course, is our segments, final segments on the show. And the first segment is X's or O's. That's brought to us by Tuminugan Farm, your private paradise at the heart of Bukidnon. If you need to relax and unwind, why not rejuvenate and reconnect with nature? Right at the foot of the Kitanglad Mountain Range in Bukidnon. Choose from a wide range of accommodations like the farmhouse, the bungalow, the cottage, or the tulugan. Tuminugan Farm can accommodate entire families, groups of friends, backpackers, and even team-building events. So check out tuminuganfarm.com on Instagram and Facebook. Go to that website, book now, and you can start your Mindanao adventure there today at Tuminugan Farm and enjoy some Hinalaban coffee and adlay at the same time. Mm-hmm. So pasok tayo sa XSRO. Sir, XSROs, I have a list of choices for you. Mamili lang po kayo. Don't have to explain why you chose that guy or that thing. We just go through the list. Just choose na lang. Ganun tayo. Okay, so X's or O's. Ha? Sir, umpisahan na natin. First choice, Atoy Ko or Bogs Adornado?
Bogs.
Okay, yeah. I expected that. No? Philip or Abet Gidaben?
Philip.
Philip, okay. Bernie Fabiosa or Joy Dionisio?
Bernie Fabiosa.
Bernie Fabs. At bago tayo tumuloy, may bumabati na naman sa'yo. Taga Cebu.
You?
Uy,
Pongki Alolor.
Bye, kumusta bay?
Ayan. Ay, okay na okay. Maayo-maayo yan si Pongki. Mm-hmm. Fit na fit pa rin. Panay yung workout sa California, sa Bay Area. Okay, the next one is, sir, Rudy Soriano or Freddy Hubalde?
I wasn't able to play so much with Rudy Soriano because that time, nagka-injured na siya nung when I was playing. So, I would say Freddy Ubalde.
Okay, Freddy. Tito Varela or Bong De La Cruz?
I would say Tito Varela.
Tito, okay. Ito, sa mga imports, Cornell Warner or Irv Chatman?
Irv Chatman.
Irv Chatman, okay. Bernard Harris or Cyrus Mann?
Cyrus Mann.
Cyrus Mann, okay. Glenn Mosley or Sylvester Kyler?
Sylvester Kyler.
Okay. Larry Boston or Snake Jones?
Snake Jones.
Snake, okay. Si Snake, okay. Romy Mamaril or Jimmy Javier?
Romy.
Joy Carpio or Joel Banal?
Joel
Banal, the captain. Okay. Cho Season or Eddie Boy Mendoza?
Cho Season.
Okay. Danny Basilan or Ray Franco?
Danny Basilan.
Bilis, ha? Baby D or Jimmy Mariano?
Baby D.
Danny Floro or IG Gotaw?
IG Gotaw.
Okay. Danny Salisbury or Rich Adams?
Rich Adams.
Leo Paguntalan or Alan Abelgas?
Leo.
Okay. Manny Victorino or Abet Gidaben?
Abet Gidaben.
Abed, okay. Perry Davis or Lou Massey?
Perry Davis.
Wow.
Perry Davis. Wow. Oh, okay. Wow.
Do you know that guy? I'm very familiar.
Because?
My God, that guy can jump out of the building.
Yeah.
he showed me siya, I can peek over the rim. He's only 6'3",
yeah? Yeah.
And he did that. He peeked over the rim. Oh, pinakita.
Si Lumasi nga naman, ganito kataas.
Oh, pero si Lumasi, skills naman yun.
Oh, scorer talaga yun. Grabe naman yun. Scorer talaga yun. Isa pang nawala na rin yun. The late Lumasi na rin yan. Yeah, many years ago. Matagal-tagal na, yeah.
Okay, so sumero nung ano, metallic gigolo ah, yung
metallic gigolo. Naka-headband pa.
tropa ni Billy Ray Bates yan sa disco scene daw.
Ito, I think I know the answer to this one, but let's go. Yeah. Car racing or basketball?
Well, car racing.
Car racing na, di ba? Nag-shift na nga kasi. At ito, ano mas okay? Ford Escort or Starlet?
Starlet.
Starlet, sa inyong gamit. Okay. And then the last one, please show the photo, Carla. Ito, sir. Si Nora o si Vilma?
Vilma.
Vilma na naman. Ang bilis yung sagot. Vilma niyan. You know, Vilma wins again. We finally went back to Nora Vilma after a series of Aiko, Rufa, Carminas, but we're back. So Vilma gets this one again. Okay, that's it for X's or O's for episode 188. Jay, ikaw naman. Okay. No? Manila Cookie. No? Manila Cookie ka na.
This one's brought to us by Manila Cookie Story. No? Try the best cookies that you can find. It comes in unique packaging pa, no? My brother actually asked for it, had to find someone kasi sold out yan sa Facebook a couple of weeks ago, and he had to find something at SM yata just to be able to buy this. So sarap, Manila Cookie Story. Sir, question. Sorry, is this a dinner question or is this the second question?
Yeah, that's the dinner question.
The dinner question. Okay. Sir,
yeah, there, it's on the screen.
There you go. Which basketball personality, past or present, living or dead, American, Filipino, or whatever nationality, would you like to have dinner with and why? So pwedeng hindi niyo siya kilala, basta basketball personality. Sino po gusto niyo makasama sa dinner at bakit?
Well, I like to have a dinner with LeBron James.
Okay. Ano pag-usapan niyo, sir?
Pag-usapan is yung aside from basketball, yung business ventures niya, yung sinong tumutulong sa kanya, sinong kasi alam ko may mga kasama siya, may clout siya, di ba? Sila Rich Paul, sila ano. Pero yung mga business decisions niya, hanga ko eh.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe I can learn from him.
There you go. Okay.
And not basketball, ah. It's business. It's the business side.
It's the business side. Well, basketball, hindi na natin pag-uusapan kung anong na-accomplish niya. So, given na yon yung basketball.
Correct.
So, ang gusto pag-usapan, sir, how did you do this? How did you amass so much fortune out of like things like this?
Mm-hmm. Since you mentioned LeBron James, sir, no? So, sino ang GOAT ninyo?
Yeah, GOAT ko, LeBron James.
LeBron James.
Oh, yeah. Really? LeBron James. Okay. About sa Pilipinas, sino ang GOAT?
Ang goat ko sa Pilipinas. Hindi ko maano eh. I would say Ramon Fernandez.
That's the usual answer naman, sir.
Kahit na hindi magka-rival teams kami, pero I look up to him so much.
Nabantayan niyo ba siya, sir?
Oo, nabantayan.
How was it like? Ayun, Shabin, do you have a Fernandez story? Just to ano lang?
Hindi naman kasi usually pagka ano, hindi kami masyado binabantayan. Kumbaga, yung ano. So, masakit si Mon. Kasi, matutuli si Mon. Pagka
I knew it. I knew that would come out. Oh, yun naman talaga yun eh. Matulis daw lahat. Hindi lang siko eh. Lahat daw eh.
Ang
talino
ba?
Di ba? No, but it's great that you say on this show, 99% of the time when we ask who the best was or is, it's Mon Fernandez. on this show, kasi we have a certain audience, di ba?
Yeah.
You know, na medyo from that generation. If you ask the younger ones now, they'll say, you know, whoever else, no? Patrimonio, Jude Mar Fajardo, whatever. Mm-hmm. But yeah. But then, okay, so that it's Mon Fernandez for Mr. Phil Gulfin. Okay, may pahabol pang questions, Jay? Wala na before we enter the Hello Porky?
I guess yung ano na, I just have to ano lang. Your five favorite players of all time in the PBA.
In the PBA.
Regardless of ano, regardless of team and generation.
Oh, okay. Five top players.
Regardless of team and generation.
Yes. Your favorite nyo.
Okay. One is Mon Fernandez.
Mm-hmm.
Atoy Ko, Bogs Adornado, Alvin Patrimonio, and I would say the fifth one is Ricardo Brown.
Wow, that's a strong five right there.
Yeah.
That's all MVPs, multiple except for Atoy, di ba? And si Brown one lang din pala.
Yeah.
But you have Bogs 3, Alvin 4, Mon 4, MVPs. Lakas nun.
Galing.
Oh. Ang lakas nun. Tsaka ano, may mga positions din naman, although kulang ng, well, power forward is Alvin, pwede mag-small forward si Boggs, tapos off guard mo si Ko, point guard mo si Brown. Ganda, ha? May position pa yung pagkagawa nyo, sir, ha? Nice. Galing, galing. That's a great five. Okay, so, last na lang ito. We'll enter the last part. It's called Hello Porky. This is what I was telling you, sir. Ito yung bati kasi ni Joe Cantada sa kanyang anak every coverage that he would do. So, this is the greetings portion, ha? You can greet, shout out, give thanks to whoever you want, you know, in your career, whether it be in basketball or motorsports, in your family. Go ahead, sir. You can do that now.
Well, first things first, I would like to thank the Lord for all the blessings that I've got, whether it be on basketball, in basketball or in motorsport or whatever in my life. Then second is my family, my wife, my daughter, then my friends, maraming friends, hindi na lang muna ako mag-aano ng name kasi sobrang dami, baka hindi tayo makatapos. So, friends ko sa basketball, friends ko sa motorsports, and friends ko sa neighborhood. So, ganun lang. Ganun. Okay na ako doon.
Okay.
Maraming salamat sa inyo, guys. Alam nyo, yung 1 hour and a half, hindi ko napansin. Totoo.
Honest. Kami rin, sir. Sarap ng kwentuhan natin talaga. Yeah.
No? Kulang na ng beer, sir.
Ha? Kulang na ng beer. Dapat may beer tayo.
Kulang tatlong oras siya pag may beer tayo.
Let's save that for another time, sir. Hopefully, we get to see each other, meet each other in person.
May bumati pa sa kanya isa.
Oo nga, may bumati nga, may humabol eh. Medyo masakit din kalaban ito si Ricky Relosa.
Ricky La Rosa.
Oh, okay. Yan. Humabol pa. Toyota naman Ricky. Yan. No?
Oo.
Yeah, he's also in the States right now. So maraming na sa Amerika, Ponky, si Bernie Fabiosa, Ricky Relosa, saying hi to you from the States. Si Danny Manalaftaf na nagbumati rin kanina.
Awesome.
Yeah, so, well, thanks a lot, sir, for sharing, no? Yung kwento ninyo. It's been a while. We've been working on you getting on the show and then we were able to do it, so. And we're also announcing to everyone, we're going to take a break now for a few weeks. The FIBA Basketball World Cup will begin next week. And so we'll be busy with that, the guys here at AOB. So break muna kami na ilang linggo. Kaya announce namin sa Facebook page kailan kami mag-resume with our next guest. But what an episode, 188 with Mr. Phil Gulfin. Beautiful episode, sir. Thanks for being so candid.
188. Ang ganda nung number, 188.
Yeah, maganda. 188. Ha? Pwede pang ano, number sa kotse rin, di ba? Pag nag-rally.
Lifetime na to sa YouTube, ha? Mapapanood yan ng mga apo ninyo.
Yeah.
At apo
ng yeah. Yung apo nyo will be able to watch this hopefully later on. On the internet.
Maraming salamat sa inyo, guys.
Thanks so much, sir, for coming on. And thanks to everyone who's watching us araw nito. Before we go, Shepley, we'd like to remind everyone, we are part of the Globally Ballin Network. Thank you for all the help Globally Ballin gives us on this show. We also like to thank, of course, San Miguel Corporation, which powers our show. Maraming salamat. In cooperation with Tuminugan Farm, Manila Cookie Story. And of course, Fitbit, feel the power. And then, salamat sa PBA Archives and PH Sports Bureau for the photos and for the information that we get. Happy birthday this past week to Ulysses Rodriguez. And of course, tomorrow, JB Yango and Dodong Postanis.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday kay JB at kay Dodong. And then, belated kay Ulysses Rodriguez from this past week. And well, that does it for episode 188. It's now in the books. We will announce our next guest, but it's going to be happening in a few weeks kasi magbe-break nga kami for the FIBA Basketball World Cup. Get your tickets now. Watch the games. Nagdadating na po yung mga teams. Dumating na Montenegro. Today, bukas, darating na yung Egypt, yung Angola, and everything. Sunod-sunod, US, darating sa 22nd. So, bakbakan. Basketball, ganda. We love basketball, and, so please watch.
And Charlie Cunas all over television now.
Huwag na yan. Hindi na importante yung part na yan. Okay. So, sa ngalan ng aking kasamahan na si Jay Mercado, siyempre, Sid Ventura and Noel Zarate with us in spirit. Thank you so much, sir, for
Thank
being
you,
on
sir.
Our show. Ganda.
Thank
ganda
you so much.
Natin. Ako Charlie naman po si Jay. Charlie Cuna. Thanks to Tel for helping us get you on the show. Ako Charla. Po si Charlie Cuna. God bless everybody. We'll see you soon and stay safe, everybody. Bye. Thanks, Carla. Behind the scenes, thank you so much. Sir, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
A leader in key sectors so vital to the growth of our nation. Food, beverage, packaging, infrastructure, energy, and power. Proudly Filipino, through our well-loved brands, we carry the flag overseas. Yet we've always held out for ourselves a larger purpose. To use our scale, size, and dynamism to deliver products and services that can unlock and accelerate new opportunities for growth and drive our economy forward. We are committed to contribute to a resilient and globally competitive Philippines, where businesses like San Miguel can use their resources and imagination to expand the economy and ensure that prosperity is widely shared. Today, our focus is on generating investments and projects that will enable our country to achieve its full promise. Malasakit is woven into all that we do, from ensuring that more Filipinos are food secure, have access to reliable, sustainable, and affordable energy, world-class roads, airports, mass transit, stronger communities, and greater economic opportunities. We are helping build the Philippines that can carry our 110 million strong population into a future whose defining challenges of our time will be an energy transition, resource scarcity, and the need for greater inclusiveness. As a company, we have set our sights on building the nation of our dreams. By leveraging our expertise, leadership, and reach, as San Miguel, we will do what it takes to build a better future for all Filipinos.